Слева пудри тополя, справа генерала, На груди парикария, челка либерала, Щеки твои алые, очи голубые, Разговоры малые, доводы любые. Не были так синие, как глаза твои кантария синие. Спой мне, моя милая, что-нибудь из России, Арию графини с радио России.
Thou art the armorer of the heart. Sing me a ditty, something from Rossini, Rosina, perhaps, like on Radio Rossia. As in a chariot race, the chosen one, glistening like quartz in his roaring metal carapace, whips this way along the course, but the chariot is cleverer, throwing up stones, crashes the barrier and crushes the marrow from bones. So, setting out rooks and queens in their checkered chambers, culture leads fear down the gauntlet of human nature, stinking of laurel reeds, steeped in a boiling pan, to where there's a lively trade in the living unit of man.
Вспомни о том, как в усадьбе родной в 200-летней аллее кости лежат под березовкой, отсвечивая и галея. Люба в России не будь, подруги старикочек подруга, мало от нас было порока, мы не поддержали друг друга. Снова мы в комнатке детской лежим с пеленутой тупо.
Sing to me of how, on an ancient alley, on your family's estate, the weathered bones lay bleached and scattered under a birch tree. Quietly they chattered. There was no point to us. We didn't lend each other our hands. Like babes, we lay in the nursery in our swaddling bands.
Цветок умирает под кожей стекла. Роток почернел, и культя затекла. Земля за убитых, она сохранит их. И в должное время представят тела. Разумные звери выходят на суд. Свидетельский ящик, прозрачный сосуд. Там темное и текло, дорожка намокла. И видно, как соку щенята сосут. Судья поднимает глаза с полировки на низкую лампу дневного огня. Берет распечатки ориентировки и спросит присяжных, прощать ли меня. И не прерывая уже разговора, вчерашние братья выходят из бора в обугленных шкурах, в болотной грязи, садятся в телегу, а ну-ка вези туда, где поляна палатку держала, стянули тропу травянистые жала и держат, как стропы, дорогу назад, чтоб даже надежду она не рожала. А как оправдаться? Язык едока покажет отчетливый след молока, древесные кольца покажет бумага, следы топора и слова дурака про магна и магу.
Serpents and all deeps, tin soldiers at the city walls, all the ranks of angels, Nanny Liana digging vegetables, snow like wool and hoarfrost like ashes, throat like spindrift, legs like a foal, heart thrust through the noose like a button through a buttonhole. Save us from the right hand of falsehood. A memory won't save us, lies in the ashes biting its own tail. He taketh not pleasure in the legs of a man or the strength of a horse.
And as I'm following the newspapers in English-speaking countries, I noticed that the number of similarities is growing with every single month. Everyone is borrowing from the 70s, from the 30s, as if the language of the past was the only active layer of language. And it says something for me. It is, you know, a beginning of a diagnosis. We are influenced and maybe inflected by the past. What strikes me maybe the most about this new, I wouldn't call it modern or even postmodern, this new past-obsessed sensibility is that it takes, it doesn't see any difference. You can dig on any level of depth. You can borrow everywhere because it is using history without remembering the roots or the dates or the meanings. It is, in fact, it's a way of colonizing history.
Mm-hmm.
There is something new about the Moscow poetry landscape. I was organizing a number of poetry events during the last 12 months, and the number of audiences are increasing, and increasing rapidly. The usual number of people attending a poetic reading is as here in London as everywhere. It is from 30 to 50 persons, maybe more. You're lucky if it is 30 or 50, but well, in fact, it starts with 10. It is the same everywhere. So when the number of people coming over to listen to a poet or the number of poets were for instance, 100 or 200 or even 5, it is certain events, it has to mean something.